That's the magazine. It was built around the waning years of the Thomas Jefferson administration. And this is the origins of the right to bear arms. Gunpowder was stored here because they didn't trust you to have it at home, not wanting you to blow yourself up, what with kerosene or candle type illumination schemes. So you'd have to come down here to get gunpowder in small allotments for your personal hunting needs. And it's got a lovely view of the Charles in this kind of pavilion thing. And there's downtown Boston. This is looking at it from the backside. Note the huge stone buttress. Which tells you that reinforcement was needed as a hedge against the gunpowder going off. And that's Memorial Drive out in the distance. Magazine Beach Park, or reservation or whatever, is a fairly extensive thing, ostensibly owned by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Here's the front of the old magazine. Start wandering around and explore. Here we have a little wading pool that's gone to seed. In the bottomless stinginess of a commonwealth that takes its cues from Grover Norquist. There's a maintained swimming pool there, presumably something for kids as well. This probably failed the insurance value test or something. Oh, no booze, no smoking, no horseplay, no nothing. The heck with you. 24 inches maximum depth. And please shower before entering the pool. My God, they have a lot of anxieties. It's closed anyway. This walkway ramp system provides safe access and egress to the place for getting around the perils of busy Memorial Drive. Over here, it's mostly little athletic fields and parking areas. And you got a bit of remnant swale and whatnot. Now, follow the river upstream briefly and see what's going on up there. The place has this wonderful, constant breeze from the thermo differential between the water surface of the Charles and the surrounding land. It's totally heavenly on a hot summer day. And probably gave a few centuries worth of people relief. Seems like nearly every form of river craft in the world has been dragged here so that you can have pretend multi-location tourism businesses. The pool doesn't seem to be open. Back in the day, people would just come down and swim in the river, which we probably do again since we cleaned it up. But I don't know how popular an option it's likely to be. I'm probably early, or this is their day off, or they just run the thing so that people can have jobs, but heaven help you actually letting anyone use it. That might cause liability problems, or cost money that belongs to Grover Norquist. Attraction up at this end, as I seem to recall, is a boathouse for sculling, rowing kinds of activities. Water's looking reasonably clean. Not too much turbidity. It's my hallmark. If it's got a lot of suspended crab in it, it probably needs some work. It's a wind-blown mulberry bush. But I won't go around it because I'll end up in the drink. Man, this looks like old fruit trees left from the days when someone had a farm here or something. You can see some of the rowing skulls sheltered beneath the trees in this grass. Yeah, these are like pear trees or cherry trees, I think. Most likely. And there's the boat for the rowing coach to yell at the scholars to row faster. Oh, and look, it's a cute little kind of benchish thing. We have ye olde boathouse, dating back, as this thing informs us, to 1869. And it involves Brookline High School, Simmons College. Gets us to the end of this stretch. Harvard Square is up this way. And of course the View Bridge is down this way.